In this video, we do some more practice with the properties of logs, and we evaluate these three problems. This is part 10 of Logarithms. In part 9, we were evaluating logs, but we said the log of 3 base b was like some letter, like x, etc. Now we're actually going to give it a value, like 0.5, and we have the log of 5 of that same base is going to be 0.7. You could figure out what the base is. It would be very difficult, but with a calculator and some knowledge you could do that, but let's not worry about that. So first we've got the log base b of 1.8. What does that mean? Well, that means 1 and 8 tenths or 18 tenths. So I'm going to write that as 18 tenths because the key in most of these problems is to get it into a fractional form or a factored form. Now what? Well, I can reduce that to 9/5. Okay, now I've got a quotient. So I could take the log base 5 of 9 minus the log, I'm sorry, that was log base b of 9 minus the log base b of 5. All right, now here's the problem. I only know what the log of 3 is and the log of 5. So what could I do with this 9? I could write that as 3 squared. So I'm going to rewrite that as log base b of 3 squared minus the log base b of 5. Getting closer. Oh, and actually I know the log base b of 5, right? You could plug that in right now because I said the log base b of 5 is 0.7. So this is just the number 0.7, actually. I don't have to write log of 5 base b anymore. And what am I going to do with this? Well, I can pull the 2 out to the front. 2 log base b of 3 minus the 0.7. And then I know the log of 3 base b that's given up here is 0.5. So I have 2 times 0.5 minus 0.7. Right? What's 2 times 0.5? I'll tell you an easy way to think of that. That's 2 times a half. That's just 1. So 1 minus 0.7. What's that? I think of like that as a dollar minus 70 cents, 0.3. Just saying the way I think about it. You can work with decimals in many different ways, including you can get out a calculator. So the final answer to the log of 1.8 base b is 0.3. Okay, here's another one. Why don't you put the video on pause and try this one on your own first. Okay, all right, so what do we have? We have the log base b of the square root of something. So the first thing we need to do is rewrite that square root in exponential form, from radical form to exponential form. And that would be 5/3 to the 1/2 power. All right, now that I have this exponent up here, I can pull it out to the front, and I've got the log of 5/3. And now I've got the log of a quotient. So it's at this point I could write that as the difference of the log of the numerator minus the log of the denominator. So what I could do is leave the 1/2 out in front and in parentheses just write log base b of 5 minus log base b of 3. So I could deal with all that, the 1/2 later after I simplify inside parentheses. But you could distribute it now if you'd like. All right, so what's the log of 5? Well, I look up here. The log of 5 was 0.7 and the log of 3 was 0.5. Hey, this is going to be kind of nice. So I have 1/2 times, what's 0.7 minus 0.5? That's going to be 0.2. And what's 0.2 divided by 2, or 1/2 of 0.2? That's going to be 0.1, or 1/10. Remember, that's how you could really read that. All right, so there you are. Okay, here's another one for you to try on your own first. Put the video on pause and try that. All right. Working with this decimals, it's usually going to be easier to put it in terms of a fraction. So what is this, 0.04? That means 4/100. Alright, so we really have the log base b of 4 hundredths. Okay, that's not going to help us here with what I have up here. I've got the log of 3 and the log of 5. So let's reduce that. That's 1/25. Well, I don't have the log of 25, but I have the log of 5, so I could write that as 5 squared. So this will give me the log base b of the numerator, which is 1, minus the log base b of the denominator. And how about I write that 25 as 5 squared. Now, do you remember what the log of 1 was equal to? B to the what power equals 1? 0. So this is just going to be 0 minus, right, I can put the 2 out in front, 2 log base b of 5. Almost done. So it's negative 2. And what's the log of 5 base b? 0.7. All right. So we have negative 2 times 0.7. So it's a negative times a positive, so it's negative. You do 2 times 7, which is 14, and bring your decimal in 1. And there is our answer. Okay, I'm going to give you a slightly different way of looking at this exact same problem. The beginning is the same. When I get up to the log of 1/25, I just want to show you another way you can write the log of 1/25. So let's say I got up to this point, log base b of 1/25. Notice you could write that as the log base b of 25 to the negative 1 power, or you could have written that as 1 over 5 squared first, which is log base b of, which means we could have just put that minus sign out in front right at that point. That's what I meant to write. Negative log base b of 25. And now I'm going to just write the b as, 25 is 5 squared. All right, see what I did? I took that negative 1, put it out in front. So you still were going to get that negative 2, right? See when you put the 2 out there? Negative 2 log base b of 5. Everything from there on is exactly the same. You're still going to get negative 1.4. One other way, and we did all this when you, if hopefully you looked at my videos on exponents, we fooled around and did things like this as well. It just depends, the more you know, the easier it is. So when I have log base b of 1 over 25, the other way I could have written this is log base b of 1 over 5 squared, and then I could have written that as log base b of 5 to the negative 2. Once again, we're going to end up with pulling that negative 2 out of the front this time. Log base b of 5. Okay, and from there on, I still am going to get the negative 2 times 0.7 is negative 1.4. So this is just practicing. You got to use all your skills in multiplying with decimals, in practicing your laws of exponents, practicing your properties of logs, etc.